Hello, welcome back. What I am going to show you today is how to take a raw print like this and turn it into a really shiny print like this in minutes using card scrapers. Stay tuned and I'll show you what I'm talking about. So I've been following a bunch of people and doing this myself is you get a large 3D print or even a small 3D print and you end up sanding and sanding and sanding and then trying to get all the layer lines gone. It takes forever, but the results can really pay for themselves. It gives you something that looks less like a 3D print and an actual prop. Problem is how much time this takes. I was watching a carpentry video recently and my father used to use these and they're called card scrapers. Now card scrapers, they're nothing more than like say spring steel or stainless steel, something fairly hard. And you take this little edge here, you basically create a little burr that's folded over like that. And these things are like razor sharp. These things shave a 3D print. They don't sand a 3D print. So a couple things happen. One is that leaves you a really, really nice surface. Two is that you can take off a lot of material really fast. Now, when I say a lot of material, not a lot in the sense of it is ruining or changing the dimensions of your print, more on the sense that it is smoothing things out and you can get rid of layer lines in seconds versus minutes and hours and having to go through different stages of like say 60 grit, 120 grit, 300 grit, up to 1,000 some odd grit. You can avoid all of that. Ones like this, they're great. Issues are is that they're fairly big. So if you're doing a large 3D print, this is perfect, but it can be a bit of a problem. And that was a bit of an issue when I first started with this guy. Now, this guy is nothing more than a handle I found on Thingiverse. I just got it because it's kind of curvy. And if you want a handle like this, the link will be down below. And so I took it and I threw it into my vise and I did a scrape. This took me about 10-15 minutes to get to this phase. This is crazy. I honestly would look at something like this and to get it to that texture, I'm thinking it would probably be minimum an hour to get to that sanding phase. Three coats of paint, literally three coats of paint and that's it. I roughed up the surface of the first one that I scraped just a little bit with some 120 grit just so the paint would stick. Three coats of paint. Seriously, this is freaking crazy because it happens so fast. Now, earlier I was talking about there being problems with the size. So there are guitar makers or luthiers, instrument makers called luthiers. And if I'm saying that wrong, I'm sorry, but it is what it is. They have these little tiny ones, about yay big, with nice little tiny curves in them. They're a lot thinner and a little more flexible, but if you're doing small prints, these things are amazing, especially if you want to get the inside of something. Totally fit these things onto the inside of stuff. A couple things that you're going to need. Here, I'm going to show you basically how to sharpen them. First, you grab the piece that you have or the card scraper, and you want to file off all the edges. Then you want to take this this thing. Hardened steel, and I've heard people can use screwdriver shafts or maybe linear rail shafts or something like that, but you know, in the end, these things are $20, so it'll pay itself off in just saving you the cost of sandpaper. Take this guy and you start working the edge over so that when you have an edge like this, will be the piece of metal you lay down on a table like that. And this will be the edge. And what you do is take the burnisher and you run it across the edge like this, fairly hard. You want to put some weight into it. Again, it's really subjective. You really want to look on how to sharpen a card scraper online. I'm giving you like the Cole's Notes Ben version and it's probably not right, but it works for me. So you take it and you're taking the metal and you're fooling it over just so you get this little burr like this. And then what you do is you take the card and you bring it up so that it's sitting like this. So now you place the card in a vise holding, just like that. You've got this burr. Now the next thing you do is you take the burnisher and you come in and you push that little edge over so that you end up having a burr that comes the other way around over this way. There are reasons why you want to fold it one way and then the other and not just go straight to the one way. not going to get into it, but suffice to say is that you sharpen this thing up. And here, take a look at some of the stuff this thing can do. It is crazy. When I first thought about this, I figured I'd give it a try. It blew me away. And then I thought, hey, I wonder how long it'll take me to, like, say, do one of these handles. Crazy, crazy fast. So didn't really time it. I do know that sanding one of these would probably take me about an hour. I know that it took me about 10, 15 minutes to do this one. I've been making flux capacitors. This box is all 3D printed because they are cheaper to 3D print than they are to purchase online. I just wanted a replica, right? When I did the edges of these, one of these boxes first, it took me about 4.5-5 hours to sand it down and get it ready for paint so that it would look good. Next one, I got the card scrapers, 30 minutes. I'm in the paint booth, my jaw just like... Now, I don't know about you, but for me, this is a huge game changer for 3D printing, at least for the fused deposit modeling or the FDM printers. Sometimes you don't want to use them because they leave layer lines. You go to a resin printer, but the resin printer is stinky. It doesn't necessarily the same sort of structural qualities that you want. All sorts of things. And oh, by the way, these things do work on resin printers as well. Any way you look at it, I'm going to cover this in more detail coming up. Go in the links below, grab yourself some card scrapers. I guarantee you will love them. They are insane. And again, I will be covering more of this in the future on maybe how to make your own and some of the cool things I've been doing. I've taken, can I find it? An old spatula from painting, and I took the steel off of that and I cut just my own little shape, burred over the edges, and now I have this nice little spoon to get in those tight little areas. Again, I'll show you guys how to do that in a future episode. But in the meantime, go below, get yourself a couple of these card scrapers, especially go and get the little tiny guys if you're working on small things. They're amazing. Don't forget to hit subscribe and, you know, buy some of the Amazon link stuff below. It helps me keep this channel running. It'd be nice to get a few more subscribers. I'm so close to 10,000. It means that I would get a coffee cup. For me, that's pretty cool. Awesome. I'll talk to you guys later. Take care.